the way that smells? Epazote, worm seed, Chenopodium, ambrosioides. Epazote is Aztec, Nahuatl, literally skunk sweat, whereas ambrosioides means food of the gods, a juxtaposition of skunk sweat over the food of the gods is a very entertaining combination of factors. Wormseed itself is self-explanatory. The plant is used for expelling roundworms or ascarids from the small intestine of the human digestive tract. The Chenopodiaceae, the family, is also home to some very well-known food items, including spinach, quinoa, and orach. In the case of using epazote in a culinary sense, the fresh herb is generally preferred as it seems to have a deeper aroma profile than the dried. It contains ascaridol, which is a monoterpene, and ascaridol is not unique to this plant, although it occurs in only a few other plants. Boldo is one of them, and another is wormwood, Artemisia absinthium. Another source of the antihelminthic compound, ascaridol. Here you see it in the early flowering stage.
Back to epazote worm seed.
The compound ascaridol occurs at a rate of up to 70% in the essential oil of this plant. So it's highly concentrated, very significant source of ascaridol. The plant grows in dry conditions and is a relatively vigorous self-seeder. Once you have it, you can usually find it the following year. Although for our purposes in the seed company, it's pretty important to grow it intentionally every year and keep it in consistent patches so that we can get good yield on it. The leaf is certainly active and is the main part that's used in culinary applications. And it is the seed, you can see the little black seeds there, that's most significant in terms of the antihelminthic aspect of the plant. Ascarids are roundworms located mainly in the small intestine, although they do have a life cycle that brings them to the blood and other parts of the digestive tract. It's no bueno. You don't want to have those things. And so throwing a little epazote into your beans not only allays flatus, but also interrupts the life cycle of the roundworm. And so it's a really good preventive therapy for making sure that your system is clean. The plant is also active against protozoans, for instance, Giardia and Entamoeba histolytica. They cause amoebic dysentery and are also no bueno. This is a disease that is very typical in the tropics, and epazote is one of the main herbs that can be used to control protozoans. they exist mainly in the lower intestine and cause diarrhea, and it can be life-threatening. The plant contains other essential oils as well, other compounds that provide preservative effects and discourage the growth of bacteria, yeasts, and fungi that create spoilage. So at one point we did a little test where we boiled beans with a sprig of epazote and another pod of beans without the epazote. Then we cooked them thoroughly and turned off the heat and did a test to see how long the food would stay viable without spoilage. The pot with the epazote continued to be edible for 2 days with no refrigeration, while the control pot of beans deteriorated after a single day. So that was a clear indication of the preservative effects of the essential oils of epazote. It can be grown as an annual, although it will be perennial in the warmer zones. It can become herbaceous where it grows up, makes seeds, and then dies down to the crown, but then arises up again in ensuing seasons. For culinary purposes, a sprig of the aerial parts like this, snap, throw that in your beans. That's a significant enough amount to have the effect. Of the dried herb, a heaping tablespoon in the pot of beans will be sufficient for the activity. For the purpose of medicinal applications, I would strongly suggest looking into the methodologies and dosages found in my book, Making Plant Medicine by Rich Ocheck. The plant can be damaging if taken in overdose, and the seeds themselves are the strongest part to use as a vermifuge and should not be played with. Proper dosage is critical. So check Making Plant Medicine before you get too enthusiastic about it. A culinary delight, tasty, the gasoline-like overtones of the fresh herb disappear in cooking, and a preservative where even without refrigeration, you can certainly improve the shelf life of foods. And in higher doses, an herbal medicine that can create great comfort in the treatment of pathogens.
We have here an example of food is medicine and medicine is food. You know, herbs, they don't work as a magic bullet that you take only once. You have to incorporate them into your lifestyle, and then you find that the results are positive and ongoing. Positive for yourself, for your family, your neighbors, and all of nature.